Hello guys! Quick video, we just saw a new tweet from Paweł Burza with some hotfixes coming tomorrow for new leaders. Let's go quickly through them and I will give you my opinion quickly how this will impact the meta and how this will impact the leader abilities. Okay, first of all, overwhelming hunger provision change from 13 to 40. This is nice. I still haven't found the perfect list for this leader ability. I'm not sure if this is gonna change a lot. Monster is a little bit struggling, but maybe some Deathwish deck can gain some more power, some few points more. So maybe it will result in being a tier 2 deck. I don't expect nothing more. Mahakam Forge provision change from 15-16. So I do think that the most important change that is needed to happen to Mahakam Forge is the rework or some adjustment to some dwarves, not to the leader. The leader ability is actually fine. I saw few lists running some spells with it and it's working a little bit. It's like a tier 3 deck and I don't think that this provision challenge really impacted it that much. I'm expecting some changes to dwarves by the end of the season and then maybe it will be better. Blaze of Glory, provision change from 15 to 16. So I personally love Blaze of Glory and I have some good win rate with this deck. This buff allows me to play actually some impactful cards and I do think that now Blaze of Glory will be even better and it's gonna be great. It's gonna be around tier 2 still, maybe even have a glimpse tier 1 minus, but probably not in the very competitive play, because if you are like playing in the pro rank and in the tournaments and you see that the opponent is playing Blaze of Glory, you will just avoid to getting your cards above 10-12 power. So it won't affect the high competitive play, but Blaze of Glory will be good for the lower ranks. Imposter provision change from 13 to 14. This is pretty good. I do believe that Imposter is there. I think this is the best leader ability at the moment from Nilfgaard. And one more point, more power. This is pretty big. I think it might be very good for Nilfgaard and you will see more Imposter decks. And now the big boy, Hidden Cash. Coins per turn reduced from 3 to 2 and cheaper hordes from 3 to 2. This is like one provision changes for leaders above is a small buff, small adjustment. But the Hidden Cash change, this is a big one. Hordes reduced from 3 to 2 is big. Like imagine now Peaches have, you need 2 coins for Peaches. You need 7 coins for this. Yes, 2 coins for Peaches. That's not that, it's harder. You need, you cannot like start with Urchin, Hidden Cash and draw the boat instantly from your deck. And you can't use the boat later. Now you need more setup from it. This is a huge nerf, I think. Well, it's not like a huge nerf that it will kill Hidden Cash deck, but maybe you now want to go for the wild card. Maybe now you want to go for the damage leader ability. I do think that Hidden Cash will not be that strong anymore. Imagine like looking at this, like Hidden Cash coin per turn reduced 3 to 2, it's like okay, fine, but then cheaper horde from 3 to 2, this means like all your cards with horde needs one more coin to set up. It's much harder because you, every time you play this card you need one more coin. So if you play like six horde cards, then you need 6 more coins, sort of, it's like very sort of. But I think this is a huge nerf and we'll go back to mid-range good card syndicate once again. So expect more wild card and expect more jackpot. Thank you for watching the video, see you later on stream and have fun playing Gwent. Change is coming tomorrow. tomorrow.